Upsets in the heavyweight history.
It is befitting that I leave the game just like I came in, beating a big bad monster who knocks out everybody and no one can whoop him. That's when that little Cassius Clay from Louisville, Kentucky came up and stopped Sonny Liston, the man who annihilated Floyd Patterson twice. He was gonna kill me. But he hit harder than George. His reach was longer than George. He's a better boxer than George. And I'm better now than I was when you saw that 22-year-old undeveloped kid running from Sonny Liston. I'm experienced now, professional. Jaw's been broke, been lost, knocked down a couple of times. Bad. Been chopping trees. I done something new for this fight. I done wrestled with an alligator. That's right. I have wrestled with an alligator. I done tussled with a whale. I done handcuffed lightning, throw thunder in jail. That's bad. Only last week, I murdered a rock, injured a stone, hospitalized a brick. I'm so mean, I make medicine sick.
Bad dude.
Bad. Fast. Last night, I cut the light off my bedroom, hit the switch, was in the bed before the room was dark.
Incredible.
Fast.
Incredible.
And you, George Fulman, all of you chumps are gonna bow when I whoop him. All of you. I know you got him. I know you got him picked. But the man's in trouble. I'm gonna show you how great I am.
Do that one dance, baby. That one dance. Yeah.
My name is Tony Mitchell.
You don't know how to do that?
I come from the project.
Come on.
I've been counted out. Told I wasn't qualified. Wasn't the right color. Way too many times. But I can't tell you how much that has inspired me, has motivated me to find my greatness. Here I am, and only in America can you take a blank canvas called life and paint your own masterpiece. I'm living proof of that. I'm Tony Mitchell, and I'm the founder, president, and CEO of Athletes Fitness, Inc. We specialize in performance enhancement and giving our clients the competitive edge. We have become one of the industry's leaders at teaching, motivating, and inspiring greatness. Greatness starts with an unflappable belief that you have in yourself, leading you to be passionate, spiritual, and driven. Your attitude will always affect your altitude, how high you will climb on the mountain of success. We believe that at the intersection of preparation and opportunity, success will always be the end result. I've been a successful athlete, parent, coach, husband, CEO, and friend. Because of my spiritual attitude, my attention to detail, my unflappable belief in Christ and myself. Do you have the right attitude, the right preparation, the fundamental belief in Christ and yourself to find your greatness? If the answer is no, let us prepare you, motivate you, inspire you to find your greatness. Greatness is not a right. It's a privilege. Do you have the hunger, the desire to be great?
We believe at Action Fitness Inc. that your mindset controls everything that you do on a day-to-day basis. And I'm excited to be here because this is a Catholic school as opposed to a public school, and I don't have to water down the message. And I believe that you guys have something great here. I coached against you guys for years. My wife is a Klimchok. If you guys have been here long enough, you know the Klimchok family. There's a bunch of teachers in the Klimchok family. And my son, Isaiah, is an eighth grader at Mother of Sorrows. He'll be here next year. He's excited to get here. One of the things that brought us here was, it was an unfortunate incident, but it was also a teachable moment. Isaiah played middle school baseball for GCC last year, and it was his first exposure up here. And kids being kids, there were some different things that happened. And it turned into a racial thing, but to credit Dan and Ben, they handled it professionally, quickly, and they used it as a teachable moment. We talked in the office, and we said, I don't blame kids for having opinions and doing things that are sometimes a little rude. They don't really know most of the time what's going on. And it's our job as adults to teach them the right protocol. So I jumped on this opportunity to come here and do some diversity training and do some championship mindset workshop with the kids because I love all kids. I've been working with kids and athletes for about 30 years. And I know that kids have the ability to adapt and change. Attitude always reflects leadership. And I believe that you guys have some really good leadership here. And we are excited to bring the program here. Championship mindset, as you saw, is competitive edge training, is mental edge training. We do a lot of things within the community to help kids understand where they're weak and where they can be strong. One of the things I want to touch on with you guys, being that you guys are the backbone of the school, is setting up a championship mindset classroom, an experience for kids. My daughter is 37 years old, and she teaches in Atlanta. She is my director of education. She is responsible for doing a lot of the in-service prep, and you guys will be meeting her at some point. She won Teacher of the Year using this program, I believe 2 years in a row in Atlanta. She's been in 4 different schools, and we've had the opportunity to test run this program in rural settings, affluent settings, and inner city settings. It works everywhere because if it's fully embraced, all of the principles are just life principles. There's no magic. You gotta roll your sleeve up and you gotta just jump in there and do what you need to do with championship mindset. I wanna cue this short little classroom video for you guys so you can get an idea of designed to fit into any level, whether it be K through 12. We even do it as workshops in the collegiate level. One of the most interesting things that we do is we instruct teachers on All About Me. We have an All About Me piece. It is a short PowerPoint on yourself. It's your background, where you went to high school, food you like, music you like, and the kids do the same project, All About Me. And the kids get the chance to read theirs out loud in class, so that it kind of sets up from the very beginning two-way communication. And that breaks down the barriers. Kids come into your classroom ready to rebel because they feel like teachers won't connect and won't understand them. All About Me breaks all of that down. So you put in your All About Me short little PowerPoint, whatever you feel comfortable putting in there. And it is unbelievable how it sets up and breaks down barriers for kids. The kids read theirs out loud, and the kids in the class get to know about the classmates. So you understand who they are, where they're coming from, and it's just a great icebreaker. You know, we always suggest that. We also have a thing that we have teachers do, and the kids, it's a project called I Wish My Teacher Knew. And it starts at the beginning of the school year. So kids will come in and you will assign this project to them, and they'll get a piece of paper and they'll write down something like personal. It could be anything as far as my dad's unemployed, he's been incarcerated for 3 years. Every kid gets to hand you that, and it's confidential unless that kid tells you that they want it read out loud or want it shared. But what it does is it gives you an opportunity to unpack some baggage for your students at the beginning of the year, because when kids come today, they come with baggage. They come with a lot of different things that they didn't come with when I was coaching against you guys. You know, they come with a lot of different things. Social media, environmental issues. There's a lot of kids that are depressed and have different things going on and you don't really know them. So you can't connect with them because they're in another place. This will allow you to break the ice and do some things to connect with your kids. We believe in championship mindset that two-way communication is the only way. The kids respect you, you respect them, you challenge the kids to be great. And that's what we do in this program. We challenge kids to be great. We challenge teachers to be great. We challenge coaches to be great. It changes the culture in the community and in the school. We always look for a point person in every district. I know nobody wants to sign up to be the point person, but we do a lot of Zoom conversations. So for instance, if you guys are interested in doing the full program and you have questions, what we do is we set up a Zoom conference for after school, for whoever's interested. We have files, we have links to give you all the information you need to either set your classroom up or just do the things that will allow you to break that ice. We do a thing every Monday, and we call it Mindset Monday, Championship Mindset Monday. We use a word and a theme with that word. We use the word, the actual word, championship mindset, and we've created words. You guys are teachers. You're very creative. You can use your own words. But I'll just throw a couple things out there at you. We use foresee, courage, caring, capable, confident. For the letter H, honest, happy, hardworking, harmonious. So we pick words every single Monday throughout the entire school year to get that week started. We call it Mindset Monday. The kids look forward to it. They come in, you tell them what that word is, and you work that Monday on that theme for that word. And then we do a thing at the end of the week, every week, called Reflection Friday. Friday's that day where everybody's looking forward to the weekend. Some kids are going home to bad situations, and we like to have them reflect on something positive coming from you guys. So when they leave and they go home, the last thing that they think about is that Reflection Friday word, that theme. And it gets them through the weekend. And they come back again on Monday, and guess what? It's Mindset Monday again. So it keeps you connected with your students when you do that project. And we have some icebreakers for that too, if you guys are interested in doing that. And cue this. This is the beginning of the school year, like right now. It's just like this classroom. Thank you. distinct levels to the program. When we come in, our first session, we talk about the first level. We have bracelets that correspond with every level. I never go anywhere without my bracelets. So the kids will be getting these bracelets, and you guys will be getting these bracelets. The first level of our program is simply championship mindset, and it just says acceptance, courage, and wisdom. We're going to spend time talking with the kids during our workshop about acceptance, about being fully accepting of the people around them, the environment they're in, and what real courage is. You know, real courage is not bungee jumping or popping a lily on 376 with a motorcycle or ninja. Real courage is standing up to your friend who's trying to get you to vape, and you know that's not something that's good. You tell them, no, I can't do that, I got championship mindset. We go into different schools once this program is fully embraced, and you walk into that school, you hear kids saying to other kids, no, I can't do that. I got championship mindset. I got goals, I got dreams, I can't do that. And they embrace it. They embrace it because the teachers embrace it, because the parents embrace it, because the coaches embrace it. So now they embrace it. And they have a new sense of self-worth, so they're not doing all these destructive things. You talk about the second level. The second level is one of my favorites. It says championship mindset, passion, purpose, and pride. You can't be successful doing anything in life unless you have passion. You guys are here because you have passion. You're here because you want to make a difference. I know you're not here because you're making a lot of money, because I know how this thing works. I have great respect for you guys because you come to work every day with passion. You come to work every day with a purpose. And you're instilling that pride in your students. So that's that second level, and it's a bracelet that corresponds to that. And then the last level is championship mindset. It says no fears, no excuses, embrace the process. Everything you do in life, you have fear because it's unknown. You're getting out of what we call a fishbowl mindset. So now you're doing something different. So you have a little bit of fear. No room for fear. You got to jump out and swim with the big fish. No excuses. Kids that make excuses, adults that make excuses, you spend your whole life doing what? Making excuses. Every time something bad happens, you got an excuse for it. We always say you got a bad case of the yeah buts. So you're going to teach your students to understand that it's no fear. There's no excuses. We're going to embrace this process. And we're going to help you guys do that. The kids love the bracelets. They wear them to school. It's a reminder every day. And if you see a kid coming down the hall and that kid's doing something that's disrespectful in any way, all you got to do is tap them on the shoulder and say, what's that bracelet say? And immediately, they change. Because they know that they're being held accountable. And it's not magic. It's all about everybody working together. We have a saying at Championship Mindset. You can read it on the back of my shirt. Everywhere we go, we talk about pain being temporary, but greatness is forever. You're teaching your students what it takes to be great. You're going to go through some pain. You're going to go through some adversity. Everybody does. It doesn't matter what your bank account says. That man upstairs said, you're going to go through some things. And we need to go through some things in order to be great. But the pain is temporary. If you're striving to be great, you want your students to be great, you got to go through some of that pain with them when they tell you something personal, when they're dealing with some different things. And what you'll find is those kids will wrap their arms around them. Whether they're affluent kids, whether they're rural kids, kids just need love. And we've become a society that doesn't give that love, not readily, because we're a little bit apprehensive for a lot of different reasons. But when you give that love, you get it back in return. I've never been anywhere where the program has been embraced and the kids don't show you love. They'll be in the cafeteria, there'll be all kind of craziness going on. You walk in there and say, championship mindset, people. And it's like, why? Because they understand what that means. and you're holding them accountable. It's not something just 24 hours and you click it off, the next day you're back to being your old self. It's 365 days a year. And if you guys have kids at home, I suggest you start doing this with your kids, because I'm telling you, it works. It creates leverage at home. And we all know, we have kids at home, they use leverage better than anybody on the planet. They're looking to create leverage. I always tell people, I realized when I had my second child that kids were like natural born terrorists. And they're going to use leverage to get whatever they want. By the time they're 2 years old, they know what they want. And they're going to use whatever leverage they can get to get what they want. Well, this program gives the parents, the teachers, the coaches, it gives you guys leverage now. If they want to do things in school, in the classroom, activities as far as sports, if they don't have championship mindset behavior, then they don't get to do it. It's that simple. You don't get to do it. And what you find is kids will say, okay, I'm not willing to give this or this up, my cell phone. I'm not willing to give up my YouTube privileges. I'm not willing to give up any of these social media things that you allow me to do, mom and dad. Hold them accountable. They will respond. Attitude always reflects leadership. I want to introduce one of my facilitators, Ken. I've known Ken for probably about 17, 18 years. Ken was one of those guys that grew up in a tough environment, didn't have all the things that most kids want and dream about, but Ken found a way to have championship mindset. I watched Ken go through a lot of different things. I went to high school with his dad, and I understand what was going on dynamically in Ken's world. But Ken never quit. He was always focused. He played football, basketball, baseball, grew up in Homewood. Parents moved to Penn Hills. He went to Penn Hills High School, started basketball and football, got a football scholarship to Bowling Green. Went to Bowling Green and majored in, guess what? Education. Graduated with an education degree, was lucky enough to chase down his dream of playing some professional football with the Cincinnati Bengals, started two businesses, and he works part-time with me. I'm going to show you Ken's PowerPoint real quick. This is all about me. Ken, you worked at Mount Richland
Middle School.
And you coached varsity football and 8th grade
basketball.
So I know the program works. I got probably about 100 kids that I've worked with over years with championship mindset, and your story is just like Ken's story. So I know it works if you embrace it. Ken's been a worker his whole life. He's still working at two businesses up and running and working with me part time. A little bit about what Ken's doing yet.
I have a franchise cleaning company and a daycare center in Hills.
Ken has a loving family. That's the house Ken grew up in. Who's this lovely lady, Ken?
That's my wife. My wife, Tiffany Lewis.
That's the house Ken lives in now.
So those are my three. That's my three sons, Kane, Kenny, and Kobe Lewis.
Your oldest is how old?
My oldest is 12. Goes to Gateway Middle School.
So you're all about me, the teachers, is just real brief stuff, icebreaker stuff, and it gets your kids plugged in. And then they do their own piece of All About Me. And they can do it electronically, or they can just read it, write things down about themselves. And I'm telling you, it creates two-way communication almost immediately. They think teachers aren't human. When they come into a room, they're like, these people hate me. They're trying to kill me. They're gonna give me homework every day. When they see you're all about me, they're like, oh man, they're human. So I think it's something that you guys really should look at doing the All About Me piece and have them do the same thing. It breaks the ice. You guys have any questions for me? We're still quiet. We're all aware of the things that are going on in society. No school or no community is immune to what's going on. If I go to Pine Richland, if I go to Peters Township, if I go to Mount Pleasant, if I go to Obama Academy, the problems are the same. They're the same. That's the one thing we found out everywhere we go. Kids are getting exposed to social media too early. And they're being put in adult venues when they're 7, 8 years old. Heck, I'm an adult and I can't handle social media some of the time. And we're asking kids, you gotta remember this, parents, your kids are not equipped to deal with the online bullying, kids telling them to try certain things. People are buying tainted gummy bears and all kind of other things online. Kids are. Because once they gain access to that other world, it just keeps expanding. So what we tell parents is make sure that your kids are turning in their phone every single day. I got a teenager, I got some grown kids. When your kids turn in that phone and they know you're looking at that phone, don't allow them to tell you, this is my private business. Well, they're not paying the bill, so it's not their private business. You're paying that bill. Your job is to protect your kids from the online predators that are out there. The people, they come in and they rob your kids of that innocence. So don't let your kids use that leverage and say, well, I want to be able to do anything and everything with my phone, my laptop, my iPad. You got to monitor that. And it all ties into championship mindset. One thing you'll realize when you start doing that, they become nicer people. Your teenagers, they become nicer people because it is real pressure to deal with adult venues and doing things that you really aren't equipped to do yet. So protect your kids. Get them under that umbrella of championship mindset and let them know that because I care about you, I need that phone. I need that phone every day. I need to know what you're doing. It's to the point now where they have the interactive games, whether it's Xbox, whether it's PS4. Your kids are playing online with people they don't even know. From other cities, other states. And these online predators, are getting personal information from your kids while they're playing a video game. Hey, where you live? What's your mom do for a living? What's your dad do? You have to really be careful with the exposure your kids get to online gaming, because it opens up this big, huge world. And we all know what happens when you open up Pandora's box. You can never close it. You can never close it at that point, because your kids are, hey, I had my phone and I did what I wanted to do for 3 years. Now you want my phone. Start early. If your kids are young, start early. Challenge them to have championship mindset. Challenge them to have acceptance, courage, and wisdom. Challenge them to be passionate about school. Kids are not going to be passionate about school unless the parents are passionate about school. They're not going to have any purpose when they come to school unless the parents give them that purpose. They're not going to have any pride unless you give it to them. Kids are like sponges. Whatever's around the house, they're going to soak it up. You can no longer say, do as I say, not as I do. That doesn't work. They're watching everything you do. And I see a lot of parents that don't want to give up their social media privileges, so they just go ahead and give the kid a bunch of privileges. So you got the parents in one room, you got the kids in another room. Nobody's talking to each other, they're just doing a social media thing. Your kids are getting exposed to adult things at a young age. Championship mindset says monitor their behavior. No excuses, no fear, embrace the process. It was fun being here, guys. Thank you.